When he contacted me about this, I was like ecstatic because, I'll tell you why, because somehow I've done Paddington 1 and 2 with him. I feel, he might say otherwise, but I feel we have a fantastic instinctive sort of, you know, a rapport. And also because you can really talk to him and you can have an argument with him and you can be silly and he doesn't mind. He can take all of it, you know, and he can give it and give it back and you don't feel like you're falling out. And I think that's a real, it's just fantastic to be able to have a working relationship with somebody where you can go through all that, you know. And if you're a costume designer, there's just really the most important thing is that you have a, you're in tune with the director, and then when you read the script, you can see the characters. You might have an argument about what they are, or you might misunderstand what they are. You know, you might have your take, but the thing is, that's a conversation, you know. Something of yours and something of theirs and something of this, you know, it'll all go in, and it'll be much more interesting. We didn't have Olivia until right at the end, and everything that Olivia wears now has been made. Her aprons have all been printed and made. Her cardigans and knitwear have all been knitted, and her dresses have all been printed. Everything's been printed by Michael and made. So there's, it's like part of it, after you've started doing that, it becomes like you have to do everything, you know. That's so even things like her beautiful old overalls that she wears have been, you know, they've been dyed in a certain way, and then they've had a sort of treatment where the dye is pushed out and then other things are actually printed on them. So it might look like they're just a load of old clothes, but actually we know that they've got all got a story to them. The fundamental thing about Willy Wonka and his whole costume is that by the time you meet him at the beginning of the film, he's been wandering the world in some of these clothes. He's owned all of those clothes, and he's been wandering the world sometimes to hot countries where he wouldn't be wearing his velvet coat, and then other times to colder places where he would, and more. We didn't use the red velvet coat to start with because the ship is landing that he's been on for all this time. And so we just had, you saw him on the ship with the underneath parts, and then the putting on of the layers became part of him leaving the ship and going to the shore. And so the first thing, apart from the hat, which we can get to in a minute, but the first thing that you see that would be really Gene Wilder's Wonka world is when he goes into town, he puts on the red velvet coat. I mean, every piece of the chocolatier's tailored wools, you know, for their suits, had to be dyed to a specific color because Paul wanted them to be one green, one blue, and one yellow. That was their chocolate shop color, that was their chocolate wrapper's color, and that was their colors of their clothes, everything they had. So it was, once that started, I think it was like a moment that we knew the key and it was gonna be colorful and it was gonna be more like a musical and less like a regular sort of story, more like a musical. And that the characters could be broad.